Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about antihistaminic agents. Okay. So in last lecture, we have seen what is histamine. Okay. Which are the different histamine receptor? Which are the different locations of the different histamine receptors? Also, we have seen different functions of histamine, different actions produced by the histamine. Okay. So each and every point related to histamine we have covered in last lecture. So in this lecture we'll mainly focus on antihistaminic agents. Okay, that antihistaminic agents are also known as an antihistamine. Okay, both terms are similar to each other. Okay, both are same, that is antihistamine as well as antihistaminic agents are same term. So antihistamines are a class of drugs that are used to cure the allergies triggered by the physiological action of histamine. Okay, sometimes there is a triggering in the allergic reaction, and the reason behind that allergic reaction, okay, or the triggering of that allergic reaction is histamine. Okay, so mainly antihistamines, okay, are the class of drugs that are used to cure the allergies triggered by the physiological action of histamine. Okay, so due to the action of histamine, there is a triggering in the allergic reaction, and to cure this type of allergies, okay, which are triggered due to histamine, mainly antihistamines are prescribed. So antihistamines are the organic compound that are involved in the local immune responses and act as a neurotransmitter. Okay, so histamines take part in the inflammatory responses and act as a mediator of pruritus. So basophils produce histamines, and they are found in the connected nearby tissues. So histamines increases the permeability of the white blood cells, and this makes the pathogens to get more engaged with the infected tissues. Okay, so mainly histamines produces the action by increasing the permeability of the blood vessel, of the blood capillaries. Okay, so due to the increase in the permeability, more white blood cell can cross the capillaries, okay, and reach to the tissues. Okay, and then it produces the different allergic responses. Okay, so this is the action of histamine. So sometimes there is a triggering in the action due to the increased amount of histamine. There is a triggering in the allergic reaction, and to cure the triggered allergic reaction, mainly antihistamines are used. So antihistamines examples are ranitidine, loratidine, meclizine, and cetirizine. Okay. So in last lecture we have seen different actions of histamine. Okay, so whenever there is a entry of any foreign particle or any pathogen inside our human body, there is an activation of immune system. As an activation of immune system, there is a release of histamine takes place. Okay, once there is a release of histamine, that histamine increases the permeability, okay, of the blood capillaries. Then due to the increase in the permeability, more white blood cells passes the blood capillaries and fight with pathogens, okay, and it produces different allergic reactions. So these are the different examples of the antihistamines like ranitidine, loratidine, meclizine, and cetirizine. So antihistamines are a drug that block the action of histamine, a compound released in allergic inflammatory reactions. Okay, so whenever there is any allergy, okay, that allergy is due to the response of histamine. Okay, so due to the allergic reaction, there is a release of histamine, and that histamine produces different actions. So mainly that histamine binds to the H1 receptors. Okay, in last lecture we have seen different receptors like H1, H2, H3, and H4. Okay, so mainly they bind to the histamine receptor. And then once there is a binding of histamine to the receptor, They are responsible for the immediate hypersensitivity reactions such as sneezing and itching. Okay, so as a response to the binding of histamine to the receptor, it produces sneezing and itching, which are the allergic inflammatory reactions. Okay, by inhibiting the activity of histamine, they can reduce capillary fragility, which produces the erythema or redness associated with allergic reactions. So they will also reduce histamine induced secretions, including excessive tears and salivation. Okay, so we have seen in yesterday's lecture that which are the different functions of histamine. Okay, so sometimes due to the overproduction of histamine, due to the overactivation of histamine, there is a excessive tears and salivation. Okay, means there is excessive secretions that takes place, and to reduce this type of excessive secretions, which are histamine induced secretions, mainly antihistamines or antihistaminic drugs are used. So mainly antihistamines, okay, are first generation and second generation. Okay, so first generation antihistaminic agents having one of the side effect is sedating activity. Okay, the drugs under first generation having sedative property, okay, which is one of the side effects related to their action. So most people assume antihistamines are of no concern because of their easy access in over-the-counter allergy, cough and cold medicines and sleep aids. So according to a 2010 review in allergy, the older first generation sedating antihistamines developed in 1940s to 1950s penetrate the central nervous system. So this is what gives them a potential for abuse and addiction. Okay, so this is a reason why first generation antihistamine drugs produces sedative activity. Okay, as they are highly lipophilic in nature, they can easily cross blood-brain barrier. Okay, and due to that, it penetrates inside the central nervous system. Okay, and due to the penetration inside the central nervous system, it produces sedative properties. So after that, there is a change in the structure, that is due to the development of new generation, that is second generation. They try to overcome the different side effects related to the first generation. So second generation and third generation antihistamines are non-sedating or minimally sedating and causes less drowsiness than the first generation drugs. Okay, so new drugs are developed in such a way that it has less sedative properties. So this is because they have limited penetration into the brain. Okay, so due to the change in the structure, they try to decrease the properties of the drug, mainly whatever lipophilic properties were there to the drugs under first generation. Okay, they try to minimize their lipophilicity, okay, and ultimately they limits the penetration of the drug into the brain. So they also have fewer side effects because they only bind to selected receptor. Okay, so they are developed the new drugs in such a way that they having selected receptor affinity. So they selectively binds to specific type of receptor and produces specific activity. Okay, so they try to overcome different side effects related to the first generation antihistaminic agents. So these are the main important chemical classes, that is alkylamine, piperazine, piperidines, ethanolamine, then ethylene diamines and phenothiazines. Okay, and some other classes also there. So in each class, there are different drugs. So first generation drugs having some of the side effects, so that's why they develop the new class, that is second generation antihistamine. So in each chemical class, some drugs are first generation and some are second generation drugs. Okay, so this is a classification of the drugs. So these are the chemical antihistamines, that is H1 antagonist. Okay, so these are clinically used in the treatment of histamine mediated allergic conditions like allergic rhinitis, then allergic conjunctivitis, etc. Okay, so mainly H1 antagonist or the first generation drugs are directly bind to the H1 receptor. Okay, and due to the binding of the H1 receptor, they block the receptor. Okay, so histamine is not able to bind to the H1 receptor. So ultimately there is an inhibition of the activity produced by the histamine. So this is the main use of the drugs under antihistaminic class. So these are the chemical classes, that is ethylene diamines. So under ethylene diamines, the drug is mepiramine. Then ethanolamines, under ethanolamine it is diphenhydramine. Then alkyl amines, under alkyl amines there are different drugs, so just one drug is mentioned over here, it is chlorphenamine and triploidine. And under piperazines it is cyclazine, and in tricyclines it is promethazine. Okay, so this is a classification given as per your syllabus copy. Okay, that is H1 antagonist and H2 antagonist. Okay, so under H1 antagonist also there are different chemical classes. Just now we have seen different chemical classes under antihistaminic agents. Okay, then mainly the drugs that bind to the H1 receptors are known as an H1 antagonist. The drug that bind to the H2 receptor and blocks the receptor are known as H2 antagonist. Okay, so mainly under H2 antagonist there are three drugs: cimetidine, famotidine and ranitidine. Okay, there are number of drugs are there under H2 antagonist, but only three drugs are important as mentioned in your syllabus copy. So that we'll see in next lecture, detailed information related to different drugs, different chemical classes under H1 antihistaminic agents. Okay, so under H1 antagonist class, okay, the drug that binds to the H1 receptor and blocks the H1 receptor. Okay, so under that class there are two subclasses. Okay, that is first generation and second generation. Okay, so H1 antagonist, also called H1 blockers, the drug that bind to the H1 receptor, are a class of medication that blocks the action of histamine at H1 receptor due to the binding of the drug to the receptor. Okay, histamine is not able to bind, and ultimately whatever actions are produced by the histamines are blocked. Okay, so histamine is not able to produce the different actions. Until and unless there is a binding of histamine to the receptor, there will be no any action is produced. Okay, so this is the main reason why, due to the blocking drugs, due to the blocking the receptor by the drugs, histamine is not produce any action. So these are the classification of H1 antagonist based on generation, like first generation and second generation. In exam there will be question like classify the antihistaminic agent based on their generation. Okay, so based on generation you have to explain drugs under first generation and drugs under second generation. Then next one is H2 antagonist. So H2 antagonist, also called H2 blockers, are a class of medications that block the action of histamine at histamine H2 receptor of the parietal cells in the stomach. Okay, so mainly H2 receptors are present in on the parietal cells of the stomach. We have seen different receptors and the distribution, receptor distribution in the human body, which are the different locations for the different receptors. Okay, so mainly in multiple choice question they may ask what is the location of H2 receptor. So H2 receptors are mainly present on the parietal cells in the stomach. So in stomach there are different parietal cells are present, and on that cell H2 receptors are present. So that H2 receptors are blocked by the H2 antagonist drugs. So this decreases the production of stomach acid. So histamine plays a key important role in regulation of formation of stomach acid or production of stomach acid. Okay, so whenever there is a overproduction of gastric acid, okay, this type of drugs are prescribed, that mainly H2 antagonist. So that H2 antagonist binds to the H2 receptor and decreases the production of stomach acid. So this is a mechanism of action, how they produces antihistaminic activity. The drug directly binds to the H2 receptor present on the parietal cells of the stomach and decreases the production of gastric acid. So mainly they are used in the treatment of dyspepsia, then peptic ulcers and gastroesophageal reflux disease. So H2 antagonist blocks histamine induced gastric acid secretion. Okay, so mainly histamine induced gastric acid secretion means once histamine binds to the H2 receptor, okay, they produces the actions, that is production of gastric acid. Okay, but sometimes what happens, there is a production of gastric acid above the limit. Okay, so due to that H2 antagonists are prescribed, and that H2 antagonist blocks the histamine induced gastric acid secretion from parietal cells of the gastric mucosa, that is lining of the stomach. So on the lining of the stomach, whatever parietal cells are present, okay, on that cells H2 receptors and H2 receptors are present, and that drugs binds to that receptor and blocks the gastric acid secretion. Okay, so mainly it is used in the gastrointestinal ulcers. Okay, mainly it is used to treat the gastroesophageal reflux diseases, gastrointestinal ulcers and other gastrointestinal hypersecretory condition. So these are the different examples of selective H3 antagonist, that is ciproxifen, okay, then pitolisant, beta histine, clobinpropid. Okay, so these are the drugs under H3 antagonist. Then H4 antagonist, drug that bind to the H4 histaminic receptor, example thiopiramide. So mainly in exam there will be question for 4 marks. Give the chemical classification of antihistaminic agent. So in that chemical class there are different subclasses, okay, under this antihistaminic agent. Under chemical class also amino alkyl ethers are there, ethylene diamine derivatives, propylamine derivatives, phenothiazine derivatives, then piperazine derivatives, ethanolamine ether, antihistamines and alkylamines. So these are the main important subclasses, okay, under antihistaminic agent. So in chemical class you have to explain each and every chemical class you have to explain examples of the drugs under each and every class. Okay, so this is a first, that is ethanolamine ether antihistamine. Okay, and these are the drugs under this class, that is diaminhydrinate, doxylamine, clemastine, diphenhydramine, diphenyl, phyrrolin. Okay, then next one is examples of tricyclic antihistamine. This is the second chemical class. Okay, so these are all the chemical classes under antihistaminic agent. So this is the first one, this one is second, it is tricyclic antihistaminic agent. So the drugs under this class is promethazine, trimipramine, cyproheptadine, loratadine and azatidine. Okay, each and every drug, okay, comes under tricyclic antihistaminic class as it contains the tricyclic system in their structure. So in next classes we'll see what is the structure of the drugs. Okay, we'll see structure of each and every drug. At a time you will come to know that it contains tricyclic nucleus. Okay, main nucleus made up of three cycles, that is tricyclic derivatives. Okay, the next one is dibenzocycloheptines and dibenzocycloheptanes. Okay, so loratadine, azatidine, cyproheptadine, these are the examples of the drugs under this class. The next one is phenothiazine derivative. So under phenothiazine, okay, main two drugs are there, it is trimipramine and promethazine. Okay, both drug contain phenothiazine nucleus inside their structure. Okay, so based on the presence of main nucleus, okay, there are different chemical classes under antihistaminic agent. Then next one is ethylene diamine derivative. So under ethylene diamine derivative, the drugs are phenbenzamine and tripinylamine hydrochloride. Okay, just whenever any drug is given in the form of hydrochloride, so it is a hydrochloride form of the drug. So tripinylamine hydrochloride is the hydrochloride salt of the tripinylamine. Okay, the next one is alkylamines. So the examples are chlorpheniramine, maleate. So it is a maleate salt then of the chlorpheniramine. The next one is triploledine hydrochloride, which is a hydrochloride salt of the triploledine. Then phenidamine tetrarate. Then next one is piperidyl benzimidazole derivative, that is estimizole. And this is a piperidines class, okay, which contains piperidine nucleus, which is a diphenyl pyrrolidine. Then piperazine derivatives like chlorcyclazine hydrochloride, macrolidine hydrochloride, buclizine hydrochloride, cetirizine, levocetirizine, chromoline sodium. Okay, so these are the drugs which contains piperazine nucleus. Okay, so each and every chemical class is important. They may ask you single class, like give the information related to the piperazine antihistaminic agents. So at a time just you have to explain related to these five drugs. But if they ask generally which are the different chemical classes under antihistaminic agents, so you have to explain each and every chemical class and different drugs under that chemical class. Okay, so this is a next classification based on generation, that is second generation H1 antagonist. Okay, so these are the drugs that binds to the H1 receptor and blocks the H1 receptor, so they are known as an H1 antagonist. Okay, but they having minor side effects. Okay, whatever side effects are there with first generation are minimized by change in the structure or due to the structural modification. They try to minimize the side effects, okay, which are present in the first generation. Okay, so due to the change in the structure or due to the structural modification, the new generation is developed and it has minor side effects. Okay, but they bind to the H1 receptor and blocks the action produced by the histamine. So the drugs under this class are azatidine, maleate, then esomeprazole, loratadine, cetirizine, levocetirizine, cromolyn, sodium. Okay, and next one is H2 antagonist. Okay, so whatever drugs we have seen, all are H1 antagonist. Whatever chemical classes we have seen, that all comes under H1 antagonist class. Okay, after that, these are the drugs under H2 antagonist class. Okay, that is cimetidine, famotidine, and ranitidine. Okay, so these are the three important drugs that binds to the H2 receptor. Okay, on the stomach lining. Okay, parietal cells, H2 receptor are present on the parietal cells. Okay, and ultimately inhibits the histamine induced or decreases the histamine induced gastric acid production or gastric acid formation, and ultimately decreases the severity, okay, related to the different gastrointestinal diseases. Okay, so each and every chemical class is important, so in next lecture we'll discuss each and every chemical class, what is the mechanism of action of that class, okay, what is the structure, okay, which are the different structural activity relationship related to each and every chemical class. Okay, then we'll see which are the different side effects, okay, related to that drug, mechanism of action, okay, metabolism of the drug. Each and everything we'll discuss in next lecture. Thank you.